Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to apply color banding to tables in Power BI using conditional formatting and some DAX tricks. Let's start with the business problem. Now, look at this report. It's just showing the order number, the product name, and the sales amount. And I'm using the default Power BI setting. Each line has a different color, and this is helpful in order to understand and to follow the numbers and the strings. Nevertheless, what I want to obtain is a different behavior. I want to show the same table in this way. Now you see that the table has still lines which have a color, but the color depends on the order number. And in this way, this row is separated from this row, and then I have a group of different rows which have all the same color because they all share the same order number. Doing it requires writing a measure and using conditional formatting. Let's do it together, step by step. Well, so we need to go back to our original table. Now, as it is now, it doesn't work. What I need to do is first get rid of Power BI formatting and then replace it with my own measure. First, we go here, not in general, but in style, we just use none. So we no longer have the highlighting. Then what I want to do is replace the highlighting. To do that, I need a measure that returns a different number depending on the color that I want to show in my report. So for this line, it will return 1, for this line, it returns 2, and then 1 again, and 1 need to be repeated for all the rows which are identical. I have several options of doing it. I might use the order number. I can check whether the order number is odd or even, and depending on that, change the value of a measure. But this is not going to work, because if you look at the report right now, all of the order numbers, they are all even. So this is not a viable way. What I need to do is first transform the order number in an increasing number, a ranking based on the order number, and then compute the value. I already have the measure here. It's called rank order. What I want to obtain is 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 5, and so on. How can I get it? Well, I'm not gonna write the code line by line, but I have it here so I can explain it to you. What this measure is doing is, first, it retrieves all the order numbers which are visible in the current visual. So I calculate the values of order number for all selected. Then I retrieve through selected value the current sales order number. So I have a table with all the order numbers. I have the current order. Finally, I only need to rank the current order inside my table. So I need to compute a rank X over the order numbers. And you see that I use two arguments to rank X, sales order number and current order. It's not very common to use the third argument of rank X, but it is useful here, because sales order number here is going to be computed in the row context of the iteration, whereas current order is a value which is being computed outside of the iteration in the original filter context. That's why I need the current order. Remember, this is a measure, so there is no row context at the beginning, and if I want the value of the current row, I need to use selected value. This rank X produces the number 1, 2, 3, 4. Why do I have if has one value? Because I don't want to show the grand total and I don't want to show any other value unless there is only one order selected. Now that I have this measure, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is still not what I need. What I need is 1, 2, 1, 2. So I created another measure, which I call band number, that just takes the rank order modulus 2. So band number is just the modulus of rank order 2. So it's either 0 or 1. Now that I have my measures, I can remove them from the report. I no longer need to see them. Next step is use conditional formatting. I can go here, go to conditional formatting, and I want to change the background color. I use a set of rules which apply to the values. And it's based on the measure sales band number. If the value is exactly 1, not percent, but a number, I use a different color. Let's use this color. And if I click on OK, now you see that the order number has the color formatting that I need. Unfortunately, I need to repeat this step for all the columns. So I did it for the order number. I also need to do that for the background, for the product name. Again, I want a set of rules which applies on the values based on the band number. If the number is exactly one as a value, then I use my color. Click on OK, and now I have both columns. If I repeat the same process for all the columns in my table, I will obtain the same effect that I have in this table. As you can see, mixing conditional formatting with some DAX code, you can obtain useful and interesting results. If you're interested in that, come to sqlbi.com, where you will find the full article describing the technique, and you also have the option of downloading the Power BI file containing the solution. Have fun with DAX!